Right now, on any given day, nearly 500,000 kids are living in the U.S. foster care system.
At the University of Minnesota, researchers are working to make sure foster care and adoptive kids are given the proper care needed to be successful later in life. And their work is now being recognized nationally.
Meet Dr. Judith Eckerly, pediatrician and director of the Adoption Medicine Clinic at the University of Minnesota.
So the Adoption Medicine Clinic is actually a clinic and a program at the University of Minnesota. We serve adopted children domestically and internationally. We serve kids who are in foster care, and then we advocate for kids who are around the world.
Dr. Eckerly and the Adoption Medicine Clinic are being recognized for changing the landscape of adoption and for working closely with the Minnesota Department of Human Services to make sure adoptive and foster care kids get help they need.
U.S. Senator Amy Klobuchar nominated you as a 2018 Congressional Coalition on Adoption Institute Angels in Adoption honoree. What does this mean? What is it? And what does it mean to Minnesota?
It's just such a huge honor to me. The CCAI is a nonpartisan group.
Talk about why this is such a passion and important to you.
I was adopted at 6 months internationally, and my start to life was not ideal. And I had multiple transitions. I was found in an alley. And those kinds of things can leave a fingerprint on kids. But I had the benefit of an amazing family, an incredible extended family, siblings who all supported me and really just helped me to move towards my goals. I was able to become a doctor and give back, and obviously I just have a vested interest in it.
And you want to give other children a chance to have this opportunity like what you had and to give them the tools that they need to reach their potential. Talk about what tools children who are adopted need.
Children who are in the adoption system at any point of their life or in an out-of-home placement at any time in their life have suffered some form of trauma. And kids who start out with those kinds of early childhood experiences, we know can suffer later health consequences, later mental health issues, and then not have a family or not have a support system to help them through. I think we all still need our families even as we're young adults entering the world.
So the main tool is that family, the support that a family can give.
Family and permanency is the strongest way for a child to be successful. It is the most key element.
Dr. Eckerly and her team are currently working on research to uncover what is critical to foster and adoptive kids so they can be successful later on.
So we're looking at what deficits do they have? Are they vitamin D deficient? Do they have thyroid problems? What things can we correct and recognize?
Dr. Eckerly and her team are currently working on research to uncover what is critical to foster and adoptive kids so they can be successful later on. If you want to donate, head to care11.com and we'll link you to the Adoption Medicine Clinic website.